فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The riwayah, the narration of the liar. إذا تقرر هذا, whatever we've mentioned right now, if you all have understood it, which I hope you do. Anyone, فمن كذب على رسول الله, anyone who lies about the messenger, عمدا, deliberately, في حديث واحد, in one حديث, فاسق, he's a fasiq. وردت روايته كلها, all of his narrations will be rejected. وبطل الاحتجاج بها جميعا, and all of his narrations, using it as a proof, will be nullified whatsoever, all of them. The question is that, what about the ruling of the one who repents from lying? Tawbatul kadhibi. He used to lie, he repented. فَإِنْ تَابَ مِنَ الْكَذِبِ عَلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. If the person repents from lying about the messenger, the scholars have two views regarding this matter. Whether they should accept his repentance, they have two views regarding it. The first view is the view that Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal took, Abu Bakr al-Humaydi took, which is Humaydi Abdullah ibn Zubayr, which is the Shaykh of Imam al-Bukhari, Abu Bakr al-Sayrafi, إلى أن توبته لا تؤثر في ذلك. That his tawbah will not affect it. His repentance will not be affected. It will have no weight, basically. ولا تقبل روايته أبدا. His narration will never ever be accepted. بل يحتم جرحه دائما. Rather, the criticism regarding him will be forever. Not only will his repentance not be accepted, but it will forever be carried on. The second view is, they see the second view, أن توبته صحيحة, that his repentance is good. وروايته مقبولة, and his narrations are accepted. إذا صحت توبته, if his repentance is correct. Nawawi took that view, and he said that this goes according to, إِنَّهُ جَارِ عَلَىٰ قَوَاعِدِ الشَّرَعِ. This goes according to the principles of the Sharia. And he used the evidence of, he said, Nawawi, that the analogy for this is what? وَقَاسُ عَلَىٰ رِوَايَةِ الْكَافِرِ. The narration of the kafir, إِذَا أَسْلَمَ, if he takes Islam. وَضَعَّفَ الرَّأْيَ الْأَوَّلَ. And he weakened the first view. نعم. That's the first one that Imam Ibn Hajar rahimahullah mentioned, which is الطعن في الراوي. What was the first one? الكذب. Are you guys with me? What is the this one? الكذب is the first criticism. The second one, which the Shaykh rahimahullah mentioned, is التهمة بالكذب. What does it mean, التهمة بالكذب? التهمة in the Arabic language linguistically means الظن, to suspect somebody of something. So, the origin of the word تهمة is from the word وهم. وهم. وهمة. The ta in the word وهمة, تاؤهم مبدلة. The ta got exchanged to a wow. Okay? كما أبدلت في تخمه. تخمة. The way the تخمة. يقال أوهمته واتهمته. أدخلت عليه تهمة. It's when you suspect a person's truthfulness. That's what it means. تهمة means this. شككت في صدقه. I have a doubt in his truthfulness. Is he true about this? Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he defines it in his Nuzha. He says in his Nuzha, تُهْمَةُ الرَّاوِي بِالْكَذِبِ بِأَلَّا يُرَى ذَلِكَ الْحَدِيثِ إِلَّا مِنْ جِهَتِهِ. It is that the hadith is not found except in his direction. It's only from his direction. And it goes against what? وَيَكُونُ مُخَالِفًا لِقَوَاعِدِ الْمَعْلُومَةِ. And it goes against the known principles. وَكَذَا مَنْ عُرِفَ بِالْكَذِبِ فِي كَلَامِهِ الْعَادِي. And also the person who is known to lie in his normal speech. He's never been found to lie about the Prophet. You know, some people lie in their day-to-day life. But do they lie about the Prophet? No. Not necessarily. But the Arabs, the scholars, what do they call it? At-tuhmatu bil-kadhib. At-tuhmatu? Okay. So how many reasons? Two reasons. The first one is what? That the hadith, لا يروى ذلك عن الحديث إلا من جهدي. That the hadith is not narrated except from him. And it goes against the what? وَيَكُونُ مُخَالِفًا لِقَوَاعِدِ الْمَعْلُومَةِ. And that goes against the principles that are well known. That's first. Second one is أَيُّعْرَفَ, that he's known, the narrator, بِالْكَذِبِ. He's known to lie فِي كَلَامِهِ الْعَدِيدِ. In his normal speech, he lies. لَكِنْ لَمْ يَظْهَرْ مِنْهُ الْكَذِبُ فِي الْحَدِيثِ النَّبَوِيِ. But it hasn't become apparent him lying about the messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If a person who is then suspected, وَمَنُ اتُّهِمَ الرَّاوِيُّ بِالْكَذِبِ تُرِكَ حَدِيثُ. His hadith is left. His hadith is left. The person who is suspected of being what? A person who is suspected of having to having a hadith which he's unique at. Not unique, but he's singular in. We just finished up one of the criticisms that can be put to a narrator. We finished two. Al-Kadhib and Al-Tuhmatu Bil-Kadhib. To be a liar or to be suspected of lying. The third one, inshallah, that we're going to go to, that the Shaykh mentions, is Fuhshul Ghalat. What does Fuhshul Ghalat mean? It means, we're doing it in the order of the Shaykh, rahimahullah, the way he mentions it. The Shaykh, after that, he says, لِكَذِبِ الرَّاوِيِّ أَوْ تُهْمَتِهِ بِذَلِكَ أَوْ فُحْشُ غَلَطِهِ. So فُحْشُ الْغَلَطِ means what? فُحْشُ الْغَلَطِ, it means كَثْرَتُهُ, when the mistakes become too much. In the Arabic language, the word فُحْش is used, كُلُّ شَيْءٍ جَاوَزَ حَدُّ. Anything that passes its limits in the Arabic language is called فُحْش. So that means بِأَنْ يَكُونَ غَلَطُ الرَّاوِي, that the mistakes of the narrator أكثر من صوابه أو يتساويان. It is that his mistakes are more than that which he correct, the correct things that he comes with, or they're the same. If they're the same, it's still called فحش الغلط. So what he does right and what he does wrong, they're the same. فحش الغلط. Or he gets more wrong than he gets what, than that which he gets right. And then that which he gets right, or they're both the same. So at this point, scholars don't take it. Khatib al-Baghdadi narrated from his own chain of narration to Sufyan al-Thawri that he said, لَيْسَ يَكَادُ يَلْفُتُ مِنَ الْغَلَطِ أَحَدٌ إِذَا كَانَ الْغَالِبُ عَلَى الرِّجَالِ حِفْ فَوَ حَافِظٌ وَإِنْ غَلِطْ وَإِنْ كَانَ الْغَالِبُ عَلَيْهِ الْغَلَطُ تَرَكْ. That Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah said that it's close that nobody is safe from doing mistakes. غَلَط is mistakes. Everyone is going to bow to do it. Well, like Ibn Taymiyyah went even further. He said, فَلَا يَسْلَمُ مِنُ أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ. The majority of the people are not safe from doing shortcomings. He said, even the companions did it. Ibn Taymiyyah said, بَلْ فِي الصَّحَابَةِ. Even the companions. مَنْ قَدْ يَغْلَطُ أَحْيَانًا وَفِي مَنْ بَعْدَهُمْ. The companions, some of them did mistakes, then those who came after them are bound to do it. Have you guys not seen the book where Aisha, استدراكاتي Aisha على بعض الصحابة, Aisha catching out some of the companions' mistakes. I'm saying he got it wrong. Now, Salaf sometimes used to use the word كَذَبَ فُلَان. Fulan said a lie. Sometimes Salaf used to call each other that name. كَذِبَ فُلَان. Fulan said a lie. That doesn't mean he lied in the sense where we would understand it. It means he got it wrong. Or what he stated is the opposite to the reality. And I mentioned that before when I was talking about كَذِبَ. But وَإِذَا كَثُرَ غَلَطُ الرَّاوِيُّ تُرِكَ حَدِيثُ. If his mistakes become too much, his hadith is left. His hadith. Abdurrahman ibn Mahdi said, لا يترك حديث رجل. A narration of a man or an individual is not left. إلا رجلا متهما. Except a person who is suspected of lying. أو رجلا الغالب عليه الغلط. Or an individual who the majority of his narrations are mistakes. That person is left. The fourth is, Ibn Hajar mentions, Al-Ghafla, heedlessness. The fourth one is Al-Ghafla, heedlessness. يُقَالُ غَفَلَ الرَّجُلُ عَنِ الشَّيْءِ يَغْفَلُ غُفُولًا فَوْغَافِلْ وَرَجُلٌ مُغَفَّلٌ. The person is called a مُغَفَّل, a heedless person. In the Arabic language, is لَا فِطْنَةَ لَهُ. Anyone who does it, he's not alert. Is called a person who's ghafil. Also, his hadith is not taken. Technically, what does it mean? غَيْبَةُ الشَّيْءٍ بَالِ الْإِنسَانِ وَعَدَمُ تَذَكُّرِهِ لَهُ. It is that something is absent from the person's mind. And عَدَمُ تَذَكُّرِهِ لَهُ. and that he's not remembering it. Ibn Taymiyyah mentions 7 things that cause ghafla, heedlessness. What the first one is al-ishtighalu an hadha ash-sha'n bighayri ka-kathiri min ahli zuhd wal-ibadah. Becoming busy in other than the field of hadith, being busy with other things like ibadah. You're a person who does a lot of ibadah, or zahid, he's a ghafil. A lot of the times they fall into ghafla. The second one is al-khulu an ma'rifati hadha ash-sha'n. The second one is to be an individual who has no understanding of this field, of the hadith. Al-khulu, to be an ma'rifati hadha ash-sha'n, in knowing this field. The person is absent from knowing this field. 3, al-tahdithu min al-hifd, falaysa kullu ahad yadbadu dhalik. The second one is to narrate from your memory. Heedlessness can occur if a person is always narrating from their memory. Because not everybody's on point when it comes to memory. So ghafla can come because of memory. For أن يدخل في حديثي, somebody to put into his hadith ما ليس منه, that which is not from it, ويزور عليه, and it's forged against him. So heedlessness comes from it. 5, أن يركن إلى الطلبة فيحدث بما يظن أنه من حديثي. For him to lean towards the students. He leans towards the students. And he narrates that which he assumes that is from his narration. To do irsal, which we took mursal, to do irsal. Seven is at-tahdithu, is to narrate min kitabin, from a book, li'in kani, that is possible, ikhtilafuhu, differences in it. So what can save a person from this to be a ghafil is that he is a hafiz mutqin. He is a hafiz, memory is on point. So all these 7 problems don't occur. It all occurs because of the memory of the individual. Naam. So the other ones that we mentioned, ghafla and fuhsh al-ghalat, are both what? Dabd. Are you with me? And the other 3 were what? Is the adala. Tuhmatu bil-kadhib. Sorry, the other 2. Tuhmatu bil-kadhib and kadhib, and tuhmatu al-kadhib is adala. Is reliability, sahih? Fuhsh al-ghalat is what? His dabd. And also al-ghafla is his dabd, his memory. Number 5, al-fisq. Fisq. The word fisq in Arabic, it means al-khuruj. The word in Arabic, fisq, means khuruj. Like for example, you say fasaqtu ar-rutbata ha min qishriha likhurujiha min. I took the bone out. So you say fasaqtu ar-rutba. I took out the seed from the date. That's what the word it means. Why is the kafir called a fasiq for? Because the khuruji, he left amma alzamahu al-aql, that which the genuine mind of a person who is upon fitra should be in. Waqtadathu al-fitratu al-salima, and the basic instincts would necessitate. He left it. That there's one God. He's the only one that created this universe. He deserves. The aql shows that. Clearly shows it. Correct? He left it. He left the basic instincts. So fasiq. Allah says, وَمَنْ كَفَرَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَيْكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. وَمَنْ كَفَرَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَيْكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. أَفَمَنْ كَانَ مُؤْمِنًا كَمَنْ كَانَ فَاسِقًا لَا يَسْتَوُونَ. So kuffar, fasiq. Also fasiq is sometimes used for a person major and minor. It can also be called minor. Which is what? وَلَا تَقْبَلُ لَهُمْ شَهَادَةً أَبَدًا. Don't take those people's witnessing. وَأُولَيْكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. The people who what? Who accuse a woman of that which she's free from. What's the ruling? What is the ruling regarding the hadith of a fasiq? Al-fasiq qisman. The fasiq, first of all, is 2 types. A fasiq is two types. You have to know it. Okay? What is the ruling of riwayat al-fasiq? The narration of a fasiq. The first one is called, the first type is al-fasiq al-muta'awil. The fasiq which is muta'awil. Muta'awil meaning he has a interpretation. And this is the people of innovation. Hum tawa'iful mubtadi'ah. This is the innovators. It's the innovators. Number two, is al-fasiq ghayr al-muta'awil. It is the fasiq that doesn't have no interpretation. Who doesn't have no interpretation. The second type, which is the one that we're dealing here right now. The one that we're dealing here, fasiq, he's not meant by the first one. He's meant by the second one. Who is that type who has no interpretation? It is the one who's leaving wajibat due to his own whims and desires. You see? Or he's doing haram. Huh? He's doing drinking khamar. He's committing zina. He's doing no interpretation. He knows it's haram. The ulama, they agree on the second one. Ittifaq. Ala adimu qubuli riwayati, that his narration is not accepted. Because the narration from the Prophet ﷺ is amana and it's a religion, wadeen. Wal fisq yubtilu al-ihtimal al-kadhib al-fasiq ala rasulillah. Because there's a possibility he might lie about the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Walidhalik Ibn al-Arabi, the great scholar. Ibn al-Arabi, the great scholar. Al-Arabi, if you guys hear al-Mu'arraf, bil-alifi wal-lam, it's a great scholar. Huh? But if you hear with the Nakira, with not Alif and Lam, it's the Zindiq, the Kafir, Mujrim one, Muhyiddin al-Arabi. This one's not. He's a great Maliki scholar. Ibn al-Arabi al-Maliki. He said, من ثبت فسقه. Anyone whose fisq becomes apparent is clear. بطل قوله. His speech is nullified. في الأخبار, in terms of information, in terms of narrations and that which he informs. إجماعاً, by way of consent. There's no khilaf in that. لأن الخبر أمانة. Because the information, the news, is something that's entrusted. والفسق قرينة تبطلها. And fisq is a thing that nullifies it for us. It nullifies it for us. الشيخ العلامة محمد الأمين الشنقيطة رحمه الله, when it came to the ayah, يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن جاءكم فاسق بنبأ فتبينوا, he said, هي تدل على عدم تصديق الفاسق في خبره. This ayah in Surah Al-Hujurat, ayah 6, it indicates على عدم التصديق, not to believe الفاسق, the فاسق, not to believe him, في خبره, in his information that he submits. وصرح تعالى, and Allah تبارك وتعالى clearly indicated في موضع آخر, in another place, بالنهي, prohibiting عن قبول شهادة الفاسق, accepting the witnessing of the فاسق. وذلك في قوله, and that is in the speech of Allah, ولا تقبلوا, and do not accept شهادة أبدا, do not accept a witnessing whatsoever, ever, forever. وأولئك هم الفاسقون, they are فاسقين. Those فاسقين don't take the witnessing. ولا خلافة, there is no dispute and it's agreement بين العلماء, amongst the scholars, في رد شهادة الفاسق, to reject the witnessing of the فاسق, وعدم قبول خبره, and not to accept his information that he transmits. Abu Hatim ibn Hibban al-Busti rahimahullah, he has a book called Al-Majruhin. What's his book called? Al-Majruhin. What's Majruhin in Arabic? The criticized ones. So he just wrote a book on those people who criticized. He mentions that in his kitab, he says, it's very good for you guys to read the introduction. He talks about the science of hadith, very good, especially those who are criticized. And he mentions in that book of his, he says, وَمِنْهُمْ, and from them, from who? Meaning from the weak ones, يعني الضعفاء, from the weak ones. الْمُعَلَّقُ بِالْفِسْقِ وَالسَّفَهِ وَإِنْ كَانَ صَدُوقًا فِي رِوَايَتِهِ. A person who has fisq connected to him, attached to him, and dim-wittedness. وَإِنْ كَانَ صَدُوقًا فِي رِوَايَتِهِ. Even if he's truthfulness in his narration, he's a fasiq. Even if he's truthful, he drinks khamar and does everything. Even if his truthfulness in his narration, what he says, he's a fasiq at the end of it. لأن الفاسق لا يكون عدلا. He's not عدل. He has no عدالة. That's what's missing. والعدل لا يكون مجروحا. An adl cannot be criticism.